Hello, let's continue the walk through the TouchDesigner SOP operators. And now we are on the deformations department. There are not so much operators here. What are actually deformers? Deformers are operators which not change topology, but move the points using different algorithms. So let's start with lattice. So let's imagine we have some geometry. For simplicity, I will create just a sphere and make it polygon with high density. If I want change the shape of a sphere, it takes too much time to moving all the points, especially using TouchDesigner modeling tools. A simpler way to use a bounding object which contains less points and use them as a magnets. So for that reason, we can use a lattice deformer, and that deformer takes three inputs. So first inputs logically is the geometry to deform. Two other inputs are rest geometry and deformed geometry. What should it be? For example, we can create a box. And because box has a geometrical input, which called bounding source, we can automatically fit that box to the sphere. After that, so let's switch to the wireframe mode, we can use that box as the lattice. And we can just put that geometry to the res geometry, and let's make a null and put it to the second input. Okay, now we have some error. Res geometry bounding divisions don't match lattice divisions. So let's check the parameters of the lattice SOP. It has 3x3x3 lattice. So for that, we should enable the parameter called use divisions. After that, the visualization of box is actually changed. And now we see only these wires. So doesn't matter if we are in wireframe mode or not in wireframe mode. So basically, that box is set up to be the source for the lattice. And that parameter is only usable for that. We can even add enforcement bars, doesn't matter, because lattice only process points. And that is only for the deform type lattice, because we also have deform type points. So what we can do with these points? We can model that geometry. For example, we just open the modeler window and we enable select and transform points. Then we switch transform handle on off. And now we can model. So then you can see that the resulting geometry will also change. So that points starting to magnify the original surface. That is the sense of working with lattice. And let's check the second mode. Then I just copy and paste that network. Then I unlock the model at null. And then I change to the lattice. In that case, every of input points act as a metaball. So basically, it's a point which sends the force around. And that's why we have a kernel function, like everywhere in Houdini and TouchDesigner, where we're using metaball functions. And then we have a radius. That makes possible to make a smooth deformation. Now I can change the divisions, or make it just 2x2x2, or basically disable use division. And now I can model geometry again. So we have to consolidate corner points. Now I disable the edits, and now I can start to model. And now you can see that geometry changing on different way than using the lattice function. But if I will play with radius and change, okay, maybe we need more divisions anyway. So let's change to 4x4x2 and let's model it again. Okay, now you can see how that's working. and we can play with radius, achieving less or more smooth effect. So that's why actually that points mode is more flexible less than just a lattice mode. And if we switch to Houdini, we have still all the same operators. So for example, let me create a sphere. Let's make it more detailed. Let's make it polygon. And let's make it more detailed. Then we can create a box. Same way we can connect that box to the original sphere. And then I can enable the axis division. Let's make it 4. Then I can make a lattice operator. And it has still the same 3 inputs. So geometry to deform to the left, then rest geometry, then we can make an edit and connect it to the deformed geometry and enable the lattice display flag. So now we just can care about the type. So either we use lattice, and here we have linear and Bezier interpolation, which differs that lattice operator from TouchDesigner one. And we have point, where we have more kernel functions, and we can even visualize meta balls. So now it's a bit more easier to understand what is going on here. We can switch to model and we can model. So, and now if I switch to lattice back and we'll change the radius, you will see how it works actually. And we have normalized threshold. So that's operator is more flexible in Houdini. Okay, let's turn back to TouchDesigner. And let me show you next deformer. I would introduce magnet, which is also working on the basis of meta balls. And let's this time just to use a grid. Let's first start with just a meta ball SOP, which will be in center. I can even split left right, open the geometry viewer, and using display flag visualize the grid. Let's make it polygon and visualize a meta ball. And now I can use a magnet operator. So magnet operator takes a meta ball force and apply it using some transformation. So for example, if I would transform by the Z axis, it will transform the input geometry that way. And here we can easily understand the different meta ball models. So for example, I can change the weight of meta ball. I can change the radius of meta ball. I can change it to blend model, to blend model, and to links model. So you can see how that different force functions works. We can even control the XY exponent and Z exponent. We can theoretically use the groups of meta balls too. So for example, I can make that grid bigger. And let's try actually to rotate it around Z axis. So we can create very nice twist effects. And using attribute create, we can create a normals. So we can better see what is going on here. And let me make the circle. And let's make 3 divisions and use a copy SOP to copy that meta ball and circle points opposite way. So I have to connect it here to the first input and template to the second. And then I can connect it to the magnet. So we can see now 3 meta balls deforming the original grid geometry. So you can imagine that can be very, very flexible and interesting deformer. And now we can even add more divisions.